Okay, so we're going to talk about something a little bit more serious today, and it's a little bit upsetting. It does result in the loss of a life. But this is something that has become such an issue, a lot in the UK, but also kind of worldwide, with people just doing cosmetic procedures and not taking it seriously, right? We've had people calling themselves veneer techs and building up people's teeth in an unsafe way. We've had people plumping up their lips with things they have purchased from Temu. All kinds of crazy things. This took place in the UK. It was somebody wanting a liquid BBL, which is a thing. It's a procedure where they lift the bum cheeks with filler, basically. And it is something that is done. Here's the deal. I think so many people take things like fillers, Botox and stuff like that, and think that because it's done for vanity reasons, and I'm air quoting for those who are just listening, that it isn't too serious. However, these are medical procedures, some of them. There are veins in your face. There are nerves in your face. There are things that can be damaged permanently by somebody who is untrained, unprofessional. They can cause permanent damage to you, or in this case, death, which is very, very sad. That's why you should always go to someone who is a trained professional. So let's just look at this situation that's happened. I just want to introduce you to the situation.
A mum of five, Alice, sadly became the first person to die following a BBL procedure in the UK. Alice was getting this procedure on Monday at around 11:30 when an ambulance was called. Two people had been arrested on suspicion of manslaughter, including above Jordan, dubbed the Lip King.
This Jordan, this Lip King person who is just like, I mean, you shouldn't go to someone who looks like that to do your filler, but he is kind of desperate for fame and has been for a very long time. He's appeared on many, many reality TV shows, both in the UK and the US, and it's just, yeah.
Quick deep dive into Jordan, also known as the Lip King, brought me to an article from the BBC November 2023, whereby another client of the Lip King's had also had complications. This lady was following a weight loss treatment plan prescribed by the Lip King, and she had complications and said that she had went to A&E, vomit and blood. Under UK law, it is illegal to carry out these procedures. Now more than ever, we do need to call for tighter rules and regulations in the aesthetics industry. How many more complications or lives need to be lost before we do something about it?
He injected somebody with a weight loss jab, right? Unlicensed weight loss jab sold on social media. I did my own research, but I didn't see anywhere that anyone was suffering to this level. The BBC made several attempts to contact Mr. Park, who's the Lip King, but he did not respond. He was giving out weight loss jabs to people that were so, I guess, illegal that it made this person vomit blood. So let's just take a closer look at this person.
Hello, my name's Jordan and I'm from England and I am addicted to lip filler. I've had filler in my chin, both lips, both.
But, who is doing this to people's faces? The people that do this kind of thing to people's faces, if it's not themselves, need to go to prison.
Cheeks, smile lines on my forehead, and I've had Botox here. Yeah, I can't really move. Can't really move my face.
I have my own clinic in Manchester now.
Whoa.
I've got my license to do fillers.
You're allowed to stick needles in people,
yeah,
and inject whatever you want.
Yeah.
It sounds like Jordan got a license to fill. Hopefully, that license comes with some skill.
It very clearly doesn't. Now, this isn't even the second time that there's been complications when someone has gone to see this moron for stuff. And huge shout out to It's Becca Smith here, because she is on top of everything.
WhatsApp messages from the Lip King. Yesterday we posted about the heartbreaking news that Alice, mum of five, became the first person in the UK to die following a BBL procedure carried out in the UK. This procedure was carried out by the notorious Lip King, also known as Jordan. I did mention...
Can I just say, BBLs as well, people have died of this on a surgery level. What makes you think you can do it in your little place when you don't know what you're doing?
A quick deep dive on Jordan brought me to an article from November 2023 where another woman was hospitalised after receiving treatment from Jordan. Since posting about Jordan, dubbed the Lip King, I've received an alarming amount of messages from his previous clients.
Okay, I'm just going to read this out to you here. So they're messaging Jordan, hey, the other day I had a really bad turn of those injections, make me very sick and bedbound. I don't know whether these are the weight loss injections or injections in general. I even had to take time off work. I listened to what you advised, but it made me really ill. I didn't mention it to you as I thought the side effects may be normal. I've just seen an article stating these injections have been sold incorrectly by you. I no longer want to take these as it's been confirmed dangerous, but I've also lost out on a lot of money. Is there anything we can do about this? To which Jordan then replies, hey babe. Hey, when do people do that? It sounds as it's not suited to you. Yeah, because they are illegal. It does not suit everyone. Sorry to hear that. Send it back and I will offer... Why send it back? Why do you need to have that back? And I will send you an £150 refund. How does that sound? I tried it and it did not work for you. Oh, you tried it and it didn't work for you. It's like saying, you know what? It doesn't work for everyone.
The client advised me they were bedbound for days and the effects lasted over a week. At the time, she didn't feel comfortable reporting Jordan and didn't know who she should report to. She has today confirmed that she has given this information to West Midlands Police.
There are few aesthetic places, right, that do injections that just pop up and down and up and down. And they don't last because a lot of the time the people don't know what they're doing. And other people who are very well qualified, the person I go to, for example, ends up correcting other people's mistakes. That can be potentially dangerous because they don't know how to fix their own mistakes. So after killing somebody, he just goes about his business, right?
So the Lip King, aka Jordan Parks, has been seen for the first time since the passing of Alice following her BBL dermal filler treatment. He was accompanied by an officer who had been asking him questions. And this is what he said. When asked, Jordan James Park was asked to comment on the death of a 33-year-old Alice Webb. When approached by Mail Online, he said, I can't talk to nobody. I was arrested, but I've been released. I mean, for me, looking at these pictures and zooming in on them, he's full glam. Mm. Like, when you've just caused...
You just killed someone.
...someone to pass away, and you could be the one that is responsible,
right?
But you're over here, full glam, earrings, everything, hiding behind glasses. I mean, I'm not being funny, but if that was me, if I caused that poor person to lose her life,
die,
and affect her children and her partner, there is no way you're going to see me putting on makeup. There's no way I'm even going to be thinking about putting on makeup,
right,
or even getting ready.
I'm with you. I feel like that's absolutely insane to be like, you have just caused the loss of someone's life and yet you're walking around. But you know what? I feel like this person, this kind of attention, no matter what it is, they look super happy about it. They would love that kind of attention. So a quick little fill in information here. This person that you're seeing in this picture, the girl on the left, her name is Gemma Polesian, I believe it's pronounced. And she works with the Lipstick King, or they did stuff together. And they've been known to get, you know, surgeries together and go through all this kind of stuff. They were basically holding training while this happened. Some great training this is. And there have been some rumors about what happened while this was happening. So Gemma took to her Facebook in a now deleted or privated status, saying what really happened, and one of her friends decided to chime in and comment on this and try and defend her. So her friend then replied to the statement and said, I've decided to write this post as I think it's unfair that people are slating a person for something they haven't done or they know the facts of. That poor lady who lost her life was actually at a training day that took place at Gemma's salon. She wasn't involved in the training, it was just on her premises. The same as a lot of other salons do. The Lip King does aesthetic days at numerous salons clinics in Gloucester. The lady did the training to be able to do this exact treatment in her own business. After the training finished, she requested Jordan do the procedure on her. Gemma was not even present when it was done. She was actually upstairs on the phone to myself at the time. She wasn't present as the training was nothing to do with her. Luckily, the police will be able to verify the time we were on the phone, and I can confirm she wasn't in the salon at the time. The person who did this treatment was Jordan. Unfair, I think it says that all the nastiness going around on social media saying awful things at Gemma, this could have happened at any other salon in Gloucester he holds clinics at, so maybe direct all the nastiness towards him, the person who is responsible, not someone who wasn't there. Wait for the truth to come out before you decide she's guilty of anything.
What's most concerning about Emma's status is that she says that Gemma wasn't present. However, according to Gemma's close associate, Alice was sending a video to her family when the procedure was being carried out, and allegedly Gemma was visible in this video. It's also said that Jordan did not have a license to carry out these procedures at Gemma's studio. Alice didn't sign any form of a waiver, and it is rumoured that the pair was intoxicated. Now, what even more?
Oh, you know what? There's this whole thing in the UK at the moment where people do like a one-day training course and they think they can do everything and anything. Yeah, I'll inject anything. It's so serious and can be so dangerous. I know it feels like you might just be injecting something into the face, but where does it sit? Where's it? You know, there's loads of stuff you need to know. There are reasons why people are more professional and more experienced and better at this than other people. It can be deadly. Please, please, please be careful who you go and visit. It's not worth going somewhere cheaper just because they have a discount or there's a voucher or you saw it on Groupon. It's not worth it. This is your body. This is your life. This is your face. Don't fuck about with it. Thank you so much for joining me. Please be careful. Let me know your opinions below and I will see you in the next